Sarah Kitchen is with us this morning. Good morning, Sarah.
Good morning.
Leaders Circle nominee, Young Athena, correct?
That's correct.
And it's good to meet you. You're from here in Indiana?
Yes.
Uh-huh. And a member of this football league that we just learned about a week or so ago.
That's right.
Got some great ladies in that league.
Yeah, a lot of fantastic women.
So. Uh-huh. What drew you to it?
It looked like a lot of fun.
Uh-huh.
I didn't join the first season, but was envious that I didn't, so uh-huh. I joined in the second season and had a lot of fun ever since.
Yeah,
so.
How many years is it now?
I've been in the league 4 years.
4 years. And you're a center?
I am the center,
but
yes.
Don't you get beat up in there?
A little bit, yeah. Some bumps and bruises.
Is it sideways snapping?
It is, yeah.
It's sideways snapping.
Yeah.
Okay, and you don't need to wear helmets and pants and all that good stuff. Just have fun with it, though.
That's right.
Yeah. Terrific. Terrific. Who do you play for?
I'm on the green team, so the Verde Vixens.
Green team. There you go. There you go. But that's not necessarily why you're nominated for Young Athena.
Right, right.
Okay. So tell us about yourself. What do you do?
Mm-hmm. I'm an HR manager with EHS Support, mm-hmm. which is a consulting company. Mm-hmm. And I was nominated by the Indiana Business and Professional Women's Club here mm-hmm. in Indiana. Been involved with them for 7 years and served in different capacities. I've been the president of the club, recording secretary, and currently serve as the assistant director for the district, which is Indiana, Katanning, and Newcastle.
Okay, so that's one of those organizations we hear a lot about. Let's put it this way. We hear things that they do, mm-hmm. but we really don't know who they are.
Yes.
So who is BPW in Indiana?
Sure. So we're one of the oldest organizations around town, and we are a leading advocacy group for women's rights in the workplace mm-hmm. across the state. Statewide, we have over 1,600 members, 75 local chapters. Indiana is one of them, and 10 districts across the state. And this year, we're actually celebrating our 100th birthday.
Oh, yeah. So do you do... monthly meetings, weekly meetings, how mm-hmm. do you do that?
We meet the first Monday of every month mm-hmm. At the Ramada. Mm-hmm. We've recently changed our location, but yeah, a good group of women. We do a lot of civic outreach as well. One of our signature events is Bras for the Cause, which uh-huh. a lot of people have heard about. And through that, we've been able to raise about $10,000 a year for Birdie's Closet at IRMC.
Yeah, wonderful. Wonderful. I'm sad because the last couple of years, Bras for the Cause has not made it into our Indiana in the Morning studios.
And
so we have to fix that this year.
That's
okay?
right.
I'm putting you in charge of that.
Okay.
When is Bras for Cause?
Sure. So the gala itself is on October 16th
uh-huh.
at 5:30 at the Fraternal Order of Eagles on Philadelphia Street.
Okay. So, and people can vote now?
That's correct. The bra submissions are due this Friday,
mm-hmm.
And then they'll be traveling to IRMC as well as Diamond Medical for voting. So
yeah, okay. And so for those who don't know what Bras for a Cause is, it's really cool. Tell us what it is.
Sure. So it's really to raise awareness in Breast Cancer Awareness Month during the month of October.
Mm-hmm.
So we decorate these crazy outlandish bra designs with anything, really. They can have a theme. They don't have to have a theme. They can be clever. But we get all shapes and sizes and forms that come in. And then we raise money by voting. So one penny equals one vote. And then we crown the winner at our awards gala in October and have a basket raffle and a whole lot of fun through that program.
I bet you that's a pretty cool night, isn't it?
It is. It is.
So people want to get involved with Bras for a Cause. What do they need to do?
Sure. So you can contact a local member if you want to submit an entry. They are being accepted at the Flower Gallery as well as Diamond Medical
mm-hmm.
To submit your bra submission to be voted on. But if you'd like a ticket to the event, they are $20 in advance or $25 at the door. And again, they are available at the Flower Gallery, the Eagles, or the Indiana County Tourist Bureau.
And the event again is on the 16th at the Eagles?
October 16th, yep.
October 16th at the Eagles.
Yes.
Cool. It's such a great event, and it calls attention, as does the entire month of October, to breast cancer awareness, breast cancer methods of treatment, research, and for those who have gone through some of the radical surgeries that are needed to battle breast cancer, it helps them as well, and Birdie's Closet particularly.
Absolutely.
Wonderful, wonderful. So tell me about your company. What do you do?
So I'm an HR manager mm-hmm. for EHS Support, and they're an environmental health and safety consulting group.
Okay.
We're a virtual company, which means we don't have a traditional office building. Mm-hmm. We have about 125 employees worldwide. Wow. So we utilize a lot of virtual communication tools, uh-huh. But work in a number of industries across a number of countries.
So your typical day, you're working from home.
Correct.
You're working from home. And what are some of the things, some of the activities you get involved in?
Sure. So I do a lot of the hiring for the company. So a lot of those recruitment efforts. I get involved in performance, so mm-hmm. kind of full cycle HR from hiring, orientation, integration, programming, and different initiatives throughout the company as far as diversity and inclusion and different programming from that regard.
Your degree, I assume, is in some way connected to that field?
Yes, I have a master's in employment and labor relations mm-hmm. from IUP, actually.
From IUP. Where are you from originally?
I grew up in Indiana County my whole life, so I'm from Glen Campbell.
Oh, okay. All right. She's a Glen Campbell girl.
That's right.
Does that make you a Purchase Line girl?
It does.
Oh, wow. There you go. There you go. We're going to be a Purchase Line this week for the football game.
Oh, there we go.
That's terrific stuff. So you're married, you live here in town, and you have a dog.
That's right.
When we talk about Leader Circle and what a wonderful event it is, and it's coming up on Thursday at the Rustic Lodge, I assume you've been to the Leader Circle events before?
I have, yes.
Yeah. Tell me about watching all of the people, the male and the female Civic Leader of the Year, the Athena Award, now the Young Athena Award. Back in the day, the IEP President's Medal of Distinction was awarded on that day as well. Mm-hmm. But it's been an event here in Indiana County for so very, very long. The feeling that you get watching all of these amazing people working behind the scenes here in this county and sometimes right out in front of the scene here in Indiana County, got a really good group of people, don't we?
Absolutely. It's a little intimidating to be nominated with them. So
when you were nominated, what did you say?
I was very honored that my fellow women nominated me from BPW. Mm-hmm. I didn't think I was all that worthy until I sat down and made a list of everything that I have done that I think I have a good chance.
All of a sudden you say to yourself, man, I've got a lot of things, irons in the fire here.
Yes.
I've been doing a lot of things. Well, that's terrific. It's wonderful that you are one of those people that has been considered to be an inspiration. And the Young Athena Award celebrates that, and that's a wonderful thing. But that whole night is about inspiration, isn't it? All of the people who do so many wonderful things.
Absolutely, absolutely. It's great to hear the stories and reasons why they got involved, because a lot of times it's a personal reason, and then it's just grown from there.
I think one of the interesting things about it is you see people that you might see in everyday life in some other setting, and you never knew this aspect of their life. You never knew they were involved in this organization or this charity or whatever it is, some way that they're serving other people here in Indiana County. It's like, wow, I never knew you were involved in that.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And you find that out on that night. And it's really, really a cool thing. Well, it's wonderful to meet you this evening or this morning. You're going to be there on Thursday along with all of your other fellow nominees. And then is football season still going on?
I'm actually a coach for the youth league. We're, currently scrimmaging and playing games on Tuesdays and Thursday nights.
Uh-huh.
So that'll end mid-October as well.
Yeah. Talking real football here. That's terrific. Well, it's great to meet you. Good luck in your football endeavors.
Thank you.
And good luck as well with your company. It really sounds like you get into some pretty fascinating work.
Absolutely, yeah.
She's Sarah Kitchen. She's a nominee for the Young Athena Award. And, of course, the Athena Award will be awarded on Friday or Thursday night as well. And the male and female Civic Leaders of the Year, all of those will be awarded at the Rustic Lodge on Thursday night. Yesterday was deadline day for you to get your tickets. And so technically today you should not be able to get tickets, but I'm going to tell you what. Go ahead and make a call and maybe you can. Maybe they can squeeze you in. I can say that because there's no ramifications for me at all. It's just... they have to handle it if somebody calls. But if you would like to go, give them a call. See if you can still get in. But yesterday was technically the deadline day. All right. So there you go. Sarah, thanks again.
Thank you.
It is the voice of Indiana County, WCCS AM 1160 and 101.1 FM.